dedicated to the scripture. Amen. All right, I will go to that text in 1 Corinthians 2, I can read from verse 1, but actually that exact text is on verse 9. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech, of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God. You notice? The testimony of God. What God does, what God can do. The miracles of God, the works of God, the wonders of God. Glory to God. For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect or that are mature, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught. That's how we assess any counsel, any wisdom, any prophetic word. Does it produce fruit or does it come to naught? Some things may sound religiously plausible, and then it doesn't pan out. We live in a generation where most people cannot endure sound doctrine, and the true prophetic sounds strange. Sometimes people have said that it is an Old Testament concept, if I dare put it that way. But verse 7 says, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery. So it's not on top of the ground. The wisdom of God is something that we, by revelation, enter into. Even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory. These things were pre-planned, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, I had not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered the heart of man, the things that which God had prepared for them that love him. But God had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. Amen. I had not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered the heart of man the things God has prepared for them that love him. I was talking to one of my ministers. I said, you are one of the few that I've entered this realm in 2018, and now we're in 19. One or two testimonies I've heard in our church, I said, you met that standard. For most of us, we're still a work in progress, and I believe I will enter into mine in this 2019. Because I had not seen, nor ye heard, neither have entered the heart of man. I know that we look at it in the afterlife or the things that God has prepared in eternity. But that dimension is here. When God begins to do explosive things, connect you with amazing opportunities, things beyond your natural capabilities, financial resources, education, level of talent, connections with people. When you look at it, it's all God. There's no way you can attain such things on your own. That's the realm of I had not seen. Doesn't necessarily literally mean that God hasn't done these things before. He's just saying in your world, it's beyond you. You haven't seen this. You haven't heard this. You haven't even conceived such capabilities. Like in my life, we're talking about the release of our aircraft. So when I was making $300 a month and praying to God for groceries and I was hungry, and God started talking to me about aviation, that's I had not seen. That way beyond my natural capabilities. And now we've come to the stage where we're actually getting ready to make that move by the power of God. I had not seen, nor ear heard. And more importantly, which is what I'll be getting into for the rest of the week, God showed me that the level of glory to come has never been seen. This glory will overrun satanic barricades and strongholds of the devil and bring forth amazing light in this terrible darkness that has engulfed the earth. I saw the glory going down streets and people running out to get saved. I've seen stadiums filled to capacity, as if it was the Super Bowl. And the glory of God would just, explode in the place. And the amazing thing was that it wasn't any one man's name in the lights. No, this was all God, the sovereign move of God. And he said to me, this glory coming can only be carried by dead men. And since then, I've been going through all kinds of things, and I'm trying to get it together because I know that I'm one of the chosen ones to carry this glory for end time global harvest. And if you desire to know more about it, then I encourage you to visit or come talk to me about it. You see that you would develop the appetite for this glory that would transcend anything we've ever seen that God has done on the earth. As the days go by, as I share on the vision for this year, we will discuss the dynamics of this visitation so that if you want to be a part of what God is doing on the earth, then we encourage you to, if you're a minister, join our apostolic network where we talk about these things. If not, then come to Resurrection House for All Nations. Attend services, visit, come and share in the Bible study. Come talk to me about it so that your life will be lined up with all that God has intended. Beloved, it will be so exciting. We haven't seen this kind of move in our generation. It's coming. It's life transforming.